Hola, hola, hola. Welcome back to Dying Light 2, part 4?
4.
Bro, this is so sick. Look at this. So I guess, like, as your dude, like, in-game changes, it changes on your main menu, too. That's so sick. Because I got that stupid pre-order thing, even though I just bought the standard game, because, like, I ain't trying to spend that much money on a story game, bro. Even though this game is sick. Alright, let's hop right back in. Alright, from last time, we helped Akon a little bit. And did a bunch of side quests and all that. Gained trust of more people. And now, we're in the Peacekeepers, I think they're called Peacekeepers, like, layer type thing, like their own building. And I guess I'm gonna continue right now.
You there?
Aiden, buddy. Good, you're alive.
Yeah, I got caught and questioned. You must
help us. Good. Otherwise, kill you. Meet me outside.
Bro, I just made friends with them.
Said he might let me through to the center if I help him.
What are you supposed to help him with?
He wants me to find Lucas's weapon. The Lazarus went missing from the crime scene, and he believes finding it will help find the killer.
The Lazarus, huh? Fancy set of brass knuckles, right? I know a guy who trades stolen goods and other shit he gets from thieves.
A fence?
Part-time fence, full-time scammer, an artless one too. He's got half the city after him for debts right now. If anyone in Villador is fool enough to buy a peacekeeper weapon, it would be him.
And what's his name?
Hubert Kerbatzos, also known as Half-Ass Hubie. Every day he sets up shop in the nearby windmill and waits for customers. Probably selling booze and weed to the PKs. If you want to find the Lazarus, talk with Hubie. I'll chase down some other leads.
Okay, let's keep in touch.
Hubie. Okay, some more PKs over there. So it wants me to go to that one. Okay. Come on, get it going. Dude, that was so clutch. Okay, so it's that one. Oh, I landed in style. Yeah, that was great. Oh my god. Whoa, this place is loaded. Oh, that reminds me. I gotta craft a... What is this? Can't you guys just leave me alone for like 2 seconds? Oh my lord. This poor guy. Okay. It's a medium. What was that? Okay, his body just fell more. Okay, cool. Oh Oh my gosh, that was so hard. What is this? Leather guards. Okay. Alright, so let's craft more. I could just do craft all, but that's no fun. So this. Stamina. Okay, that's fine. Alright, where's Hubie? Hubie. So you're Hubie. Oh. That actually makes a lot more sense, I'm not even gonna lie. Alright, Hubie.
You Hubert?
No, not me. I'm waiting for Hubie too. So get in line.
Got it. I will kill you.
Be here?
Maybe in an hour. Maybe two. You never know with old Half-Assed. That said, he's got the best moonshine. So, worth the wait.
Nothing to do but wait, I guess.
Climb! Turn it on. Why are you sitting down? We just got started.
Customer. I want to buy something.
Hey, you're that stranger they wanted to hang, aren't you? Hey, Hubie, you got a special customer. It's that pilgrim from the bazaar.
Wait, I just want to buy something. So, that was Hubie, wasn't it?
Yep. Apparently had an urgent appointment with another customer.
Yeah, you're an a-hole, bro.
Yeah, sure. Hack on. He's running away.
Nah, sounds like Hubie. Oh, wait a sec. I see him. Arsehole's running to the northeast. Faster, Aiden. You almost got him.
Bro, come on, Hubie. Hubie, come here, bro.
Don't like the look of that. We got an intruder.
Hubie, come here.
Be on that rooftop, Aiden. Find him.
Yeah, don't get stuck.
Leave me alone. I ain't done anything. Don't hurt me. I don't know anything.
About what? I haven't asked you anything yet.
I don't know anything about anything, I swear.
I'm told that you're a fence,
A fence? No way. A reseller, maybe, but...
I'm looking for the Lazarus. Yeah, I used to belong to Lucas, the late PK commander. And don't try to tell me you don't know who Lucas is.
Well, then I won't.
You know anything about the Lazarus?
Are you kidding me? Even if I'd been offered those brass knuckles, I would have refused. I'm not an idiot. That weapon is way too hot.
How did you know the Lazarus is a set of brass knuckles, I didn't say that.
Come on. Everyone knew about Lucas's little love glove. He was always showing it off. If anyone thought I had him, they might also think I killed Lucas, which is bullshit.
But someone tried to sell it to you, right?
I told you, Okay, fine. Maybe someone did, but I can't say who. Client confidentiality.
Stop fucking around. Tell me, or I...
Her name is Maya. I met her in the tenement building at Meatpacking Square, near the old butcher shop. But I don't know anything else. Leave me alone. It overlooks some army barracks or some shit.
All right, I can find that.
I should kill you just because, bro. You're literally such an a-hole, bro.
Hey, Hakon. Hubert said someone tried to sell him the Lazarus. Do you know a Maya?
No. Strange, because I thought I knew all the women here.
I'm headed to Meatpacking Square.
Meatpacking Square. It's a fucked up place. There are some barracks there. The army set up in 23 when shit went south.
She's supposed to be in one of the buildings that overlook them.
Okay. Stay in touch, bro.
Alright, am I able to turn this on? Meow, 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 meow. Meow, meow, meow. Meow, meow, meow. Yeah. Outlook. Or windmill. I don't know what outlook. Why did I say outlook? What is that from? All right. You are dead. That's my first death. Okay. Meow. Hey, boys. Wait, what am I looking for again? So many noises. Am I supposed to know where I'm going? Down here. Stamina or health? Health has got to be upgraded, bro.
Hey kids, I'm looking for a woman named Maya. It was so funny.
Maya ain't a grown-up. She's just a plain old girl.
You were the one trying to sell a PK weapon to Hubert?
Yeah, but the jerk didn't want it. He got all freaked out and chased me away.
Maya, I need that weapon. It's very important.
You expect me to just hand that brass Hoosie Whatsit over? Are you nuts?
The Hoosie Whatsit's real name is the Lazarus, and it belonged to an important PK. We might have a war if I don't return it. You could help us find a murderer.
What? Okay, I'll give you the stupid thing, but for 500.
That's a lot of money, kid.
Of course it is. Life's damn expensive. I have to buy water and a marker for my brother. He's turning 12 soon, you know.
I can give you 10, and that's my last offer.
Deal. Nobody wanted to buy it anyway.
Bro. 10. Yep, nice. Okay, that was so hard.
Hey, Akon, I have the Lazarus.
Cool, get your ass to Eto with it. It'll make the perfect birthday present for him. Though I have no idea when that prick was born. I'll be near Metro Station.
Okay.
What's my objective? Report to Ader? Oh, that's that guy, right? Alright. Sure, I'll take some stuff. The time is ticking really fast right now. Yeah. Ader.
Pilgrim has returned. I hope not empty-handed.
I found the Lazarus.
I'll be damned.
I was right that you could open doors we couldn't. Where's the fucker who had him?
In Meatpacking Square.
You didn't let him go, did you? That could have been the murderer.
A girl had him. She's 10 or something. She didn't kill him. Just looted the corpse.
Stop. We'll get back to this later. Leave us.
I did what you wanted. It's your turn. Get me to the center.
I swear, if this is...
the tunnel to the central loop is beyond my pay grade, Pilgrim. Command wants me to find the killer.
Ader, you promised!
Cool down, Pilgrim. I keep my promises. First, take this. Token of gratitude.
Bro, I have like 20 of those. Why would I want that?
Ader, I have to get to the center. Get it?
You're looking for someone, right? I want to go to the central loop too. My wife and kids are there, and I can't protect them when I'm stuck here. The tunnel will open when I find the killer. Is that clear? You can help me, or you can wait until I find him myself. I see traces of blood on the Lazarus's blades. Lucas managed to wound his killer before he died. Bastard's got to have a nasty gash. If you find him, you'll not only help me, you'll be helping yourself.
Okay. Do you have any suspects?
The commander was murdered in the bazaar. There had to be someone from there.
Bro just gave me an axe. Bro, come on.
Splendid. That's your ticket to the center. Head back to the bazaar.
Is there anything else I should know before I go?
Yes, as a matter of fact. But this is totally hush-hush. Word of this cannot get out.
Sounds serious.
Whoever killed Lucas took a little trophy. Carved his tattoo right out of his bloody arm.
They cut into his corpse? That is seriously fucked up.
Yeah, seriously. Men found out Lucas was desecrated like that, they'd lose their shit. And it would be total war. I'm telling you this, because if you find that little... trophy, then you found the sick fuck who killed Lucas.
Got it. I'll head out right now.
All right. Find Lucas's killer. Guys, let me through. Do I got some kicks in?
Still alive?
Worried about me, are you?
Of course. I have high hopes for you, Aiden. Meet me.
I found him.
He wants me to find Lucas's murderer. Only then will he help me get to the center.
Not doing his dirty work. Well, that's no surprise.
He told me to start with the bazaar.
Figures. PK and the bazaar really hate each other. Only two people matter at the bazaar. One is that overblown preacher, Carl.
I know that. Who else is there?
Sophie, his right hand. She has a way with the bazaar's more rebellious souls. Helps him keep control. There's also Dodger, a local gangster. He knows what's going on, and about the bandits led by Joe. But they're afraid of the PK.
Okay, I'll talk to Sophie and you look into Carl, unless you prefer the girl.
Sophie? She's not really my type, you know? And headstrong. She's... you'll see.
All right. All right, let me out. Ooh, I don't like the timing, though. Low-key, do I just go to this, windmill and I, like, start it up and all that? Thank you. So I guess I'll do this and then I'm gonna... Okay. Oh, okay. Oh my lord, okay. Alright. And... I'll just skip it, I've already seen this before. Literally not my fault. Yeah, I should. I'm definitely just gonna wait till morning, bruh. Catch me not doing that, bruh. Alright. Meow, meow, meow. Purple, but it's like the same thing. Alright.
We have no other choice.
Okay, main quest. I keep getting sidetracked and doing other stuff. I haven't checked the map in a while. Does it show up with like, okay. Side quests. Okay, so those are side quests. Ones I haven't done yet. Okay. Just give me all of it. Yeah, I'll pass. Come on.
Pew.
Alright. Did not mean to do close out of that. Okay, resume. Question, Sophie. I'm so confused. Wait, this is the bazaar, right?
Hey, who the fuck are you?
Easy, Chief. He ain't PK.
How do you know? They're creeping around here all the time.
Wasn't I just here, or is this a different one?
What? He's from outside the walls. Well, fuck me. I don't know what brings you here, but watch your back, Pilgrim, and stay away from the PKs. They ain't no one's friends.
This time with a biomarker.
Carl said if you show up to bring your own so he can introduce himself.
What a nice change from wanting to hang me.
I'm lost. Wasn't I just here?
He had to. You were a threat to everyone.
Of course.
Do not listen to the ideologies preached by fools calling for reconstruction. There will be no rebuilding. Who would have thought? A pilgrim in the bazaar. Welcome.
Yeah, I'm still alive, despite your best efforts.
It's clear to me you're holding a grudge. But if you were in my shoes, you would understand. We are responsible for the safety of our community. And we treat this seriously. That's why we did what we did. I hope you can forgive us. So, pray tell. What's it like in the outside world these days?
Is gossip all you want from me, Carl?
No. But you came from outside.
Let me get straight to the point. Flock.
So, to set things straight, I need to know if you're a sheep or a wolf. What are you then?
What's the difference? Sure, I'm not
a
hurt.
Sheep. I'm no threat to you.
That's exactly what a wolf would say.
You know what? I think it's time I set things straight too. I'm looking for Sophie.
Are you? And why, pray tell?
I need to ask her about Lucas's death.
Oh. Why would a pilgrim care about PK business?
How do you know,
what's
bro?
That for you?
Let's say a man's death should be another man's concern. Isn't that what separates us from the infected?
I guess you have a point. Lucas's death is our concern as well. But mainly because we are the prime suspects. I have never hidden my views on the peacekeepers. The old world fell because of people like them. Greedy, power-hungry fascists. Building the new reality based on the old values would not be wise, to say the least. Of course, according to the PK, such claims automatically make me, and all of us, potential killers. So the sooner Lucas's murderer is found, the better for us. Go that way. You'll see a giant of a man. That's Herman, Sophie's bodyguard. She won't be far. But just to be clear, I'd be surprised if she knew anything about it. Sophie is a fighter, not an assassin.
Yeah, thanks for the heads up. I'll see you around, Carl.
I don't think I will. He sounds like a buh. Sophie. I can jump high. Now talk
Sophie,
to me.
Can we talk?
Don't hurt him, Herman. Let him talk.
What? Now I want to kill you. What? Why are these people so stupid?
You're that pilgrim that came to town recently.
You're sure well informed.
Don't have much of a choice. I'm in charge of safety here. Besides, yesterday you made quite an entrance.
I'm looking for a job. Would you happen to know of any?
People here say you can be useful. I'd rather see for myself. How about a small errand first?
Bruh, come on.
What are you proposing?
Go to one of the craftmasters. Alberto or Vincenzo. Both know the location of the purest crystals. I need some for a certain transaction.
Fine. Talk to one of those craftmasters.
They should be at the bazaar. Do well, and we can think about giving you bigger jobs.
Bro, just tell me who murdered him.
Sophie sent me. She says you know where they can find some crystals.
Oh, fox. They've already sent one of their...
Fuckwits? Who?
That fellow. Sophie's brother. What was the asshole's name?
Barney. The asshole's name is Barney. And he asked the same question about a dark zone with crystals.
Oh, that's news to me. So where is that dark zone?
It's 120
That, can I tell him?
Oh, please.
100 meters from the metro. There's a big sign, fashion store, and a windmill on the other side of the street.
Thanks.
Yeah. All right, let's go do that real quick.
Well, what did you find?
I know the location, but I was told your brother asked about it already.
Herman, see if Barney turned on his radio. Barney, answer me. Barney. Damn. So that's why he's gone offline. He's looking for the crystals on his own. And throwing a wrench in the works yet again.
This isn't the first time, I gather.
No. He's always trying to prove himself. Last time he got wounded. Wasn't that long ago either. Fucking kid. I'll kill him. I'll just kill him.
How'd Barney get
wounded? Come on, it's Barney.
He didn't want to tell me. My guess is that the PK's got a hold of him.
Your brother keeps secrets from you?
That's none of your business. Barney, answer me. Damn it all to hell. If he went to a dark zone in his condition, he's a goner.
I can try to track him down.
You?
I've been in the dark zone before. In the GRE hospital.
St. Joseph Hospital? Really? If you save him, you won't regret it. We still have some time. Barney will likely wait till dusk. Going into a dark zone during the day is suicide. Just bring him back home safe.
I'll do my best.
Good luck.
All right. Cool. So, I think this is where I'm going to leave it off. Not much done. A little bit shorter than the other episodes, even though it's still long as balls. Don't forget to, you know, like and subscribe and all that stuff. Show your love and all that. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace.